rack and pinion actuator, anodized aluminum, assembled to a Dixon butterfly valve. Secure the butterfly valve in a vise and remove the two top body bolts and nuts. Place the actuator upside down in a vise. The two brackets together form an ISO 5211 mounting pad. Assemble four set screws to the outer bolt circle at the base of the actuator. Place one of the brackets over two of the set screws. Use a sleeve to reduce the output drive of the actuator. Assemble to the coupler. Slide the coupler assembly into the actuator. Align the slot in the coupler parallel to the actuator body. Place the second bracket half on the actuator. Assemble a flat washer, lock washer, and a nut to each of the four set screws and hand tighten. For fail close, leave the valve in the closed position before putting on the actuator. For fail open, open the valve before putting it on the actuator. Slide the valve stem into the coupler slot. Use two slightly longer body bolts and apply food grade anti-seize to the thread. Assemble the body bolts with the existing Nylock nuts and tighten securely. Finish tightening all four of the bracket nuts. Remove the air plug and insert an air fitting. Make sure the indicator is in alignment with the process flow. Add 80 psi plant air. Cycle the valve to check the open position and exhaust the air supply to check the closed position. The closed position requires equal distance of seat material on both sides of the disc. To rotate the disc slightly more clockwise, loosen the stop nut and stop screw. Turn the screw until the disc is in the proper position. When alignment is complete, secure the stop screw and tighten the stop nut. Rack and pinion actuator, anodized aluminum, assembled to a Dixon butterfly valve.